When you mess with the founding principles of our Constitution, you'll get chaos every time. And that's what this law has created. It will disenfranchise thousands of Pennsylvanian voters, mostly seniors, the poor, and minorities, all because of chaos. And don't let anyone fool you. That's exactly what the supporters of this bill intended. After all, if you read all the hype about this bill, you're bound to end up asking, who doesn't want to combat voter fraud? There's just one problem lost in all the hype. There's no evidence of voter fraud in Pennsylvania. So requiring ID at the polls is like asking Tom Corbett to show his ID to prove he's the governor every time he signs a bill into law. Is that really you, Tom? How do we know for sure? Please produce your ID. And for that matter, all of us standing here and everybody else on the House floor should have to show their ID every time we cast a vote for a bill. Taking such a simple approach to voting rights has created chaos. There are millions of voters with unique situations that can't shoehorn their way into this clumsy clodhopper of a law for reasons beyond their controls, and I'll give you some examples. Women whose married names don't match their name on their ID, you're not voting this fall. Apartment hoppers or new homeowners who have a new address that doesn't match their ID, you won't be voting this fall. If you go to college and you have a college ID without an expiration date, you're not voting this fall. And the list goes on. Even those who are trying to comply with the law are having problems. Some are being turned away at PennDOT because when they go to get a photo ID, their married name doesn't match the name on their birth certificate. And what about religious groups like the Amish who object to having their photos taken? The process of getting an approved ID involves completing an intrusive and highly personal questionnaire about your religious beliefs. There are thousands of people who aren't even aware of the new requirements to vote this fall. And many of the ones that are aware are confused about what to do. Worse, the system is ill-equipped to help them. I've read news stories documenting that people are not being told that if they cannot afford a photo ID, they can sign an affidavit and get the $13.50 fee waived. But worse, PennDOT isn't supplying the affidavits. They don't even let them know that there is an affidavit. Many are predicting massive backlogs of birth certificate requests filed by those wanting to comply with the law. That will not be completed before the fall election. Is that their fault? Also, there are no translators to read marriage certificates written in foreign languages. People have been turned away for that. So what do we tell them? If we expect voters to be prepared at the polls, shouldn't we be prepared to help them too? No one should be making it this difficult to vote. Instead of strengthening our constitutional right to vote, the people who backed this law created chaos. And chaos is only good when you're trying to create enough confusion to get away with something. Thank you.